So, I'm on Reddit one day and it randomly gives me a notification of a post on a subreddit called r/theglowup. Now, personally, I've never been there before, but it got my interest and it sounds like something I'd click, so I do, and it's a picture of a young woman asking for advice. In the title, it reads, "Be brutally honest, how can I improve my appearance?" I run to the comments and lo and behold, the comments say things like, "You have super nice features, the hair doesn't suit you." Hardly brutally honest, but let's keep going. "You're already beautiful, you can use different hairstyles with your hair." And the last one, "I don't see anything that needs changing, you're already stunning." And my personal favorite, "Smile, that will help immensely." The icing on the cake for me was rule number 3 of that subreddit. Comments like, "You're already beautiful, nothing to change," will be removed. But that's literally all of the comments on that particular post. Now, about the young woman herself, she obviously posted on a subreddit specifically dedicated to self-improvement because her lived experiences don't line up with the comforting lies that anonymous strangers on the internet keep telling her. There were a lot of things that she could have worked on, from dark circles, contour deformities, to a general oiliness of the skin, porosity, nasolabial lines, asymmetric hairline, scleral show. It may seem like I'm nitpicking here, but that's what brutally honest is. And the results that I can only assume she is after by posting on a subreddit like this require these small but consistent changes, because beauty is work, as any beautiful person can tell you. Poor skin indicators do negatively impact both yourself and others' perception of you, and that is well documented, not something I just say for the sake of being mean. These comforting comments on a subreddit dedicated solely to beauty advice is the problem I see everywhere. I call this toxic positivity, and it helps absolutely no one. But don't take my word for it. I wrote a program to analyze over 100,000 Redditors' beauty advice using AI, and the trends we found reflect what we've all been thinking. But to understand that data that I'm going to be showing you, you need to first understand what we're going to be doing. Let's consider the average self-improvement journey. If you want to improve your looks, you need advice and direction. This can come in the form of fitness channels, which most people know about, or fashion and styling channels, skincare, or some of the more intensive channels like Lauryn Hill, who talks about cosmetic surgery. There are many ways to improve your looks, some will give you better results than others. But where do you start? Should I focus on a skincare routine or jump straight to surgery and get orthodontic braces, for example? For most people, they ask their friends or family, or head to subreddits like r/rateme, r/glowup, r/vindicta, r/truerateme, and the list goes on and on. But there is a lot of demand for guidance and advice, clearly. Users will post their pictures and get advice from anonymous individuals, and statistically, most people giving advice are just beauty hobbyists. Beauty isn't their day job, and so the advice these people give more or less come back to the same 4 things that everyone and their mother already knows: hair, clothes, skin, and weight loss. Sounds good, but not really that helpful. For instance, there was once a post of a young man losing his hair very early and it was severely affecting his mental health. The Reddit user suggested to wear a cap and to shave off his hair. I personally would have suggested he visit a doctor to ask about a prescription of finasteride, minoxidil, microneedling, and ketoconazole, but wearing a cap is also a good solution to hair loss, I guess. Just never take it off though. Even without any data being involved, we can already agree that there's no groundbreaking advice being shared on these subreddits, but not all subreddits are the same. Some are actively focused on theory, others on practical beauty advice, but the majority exist to make you feel good about yourself, even when they claim to not be that. And so in comes r/amiugly, a subreddit where you post a picture of yourself and ask users if you're ugly. And unsurprisingly, if you do call someone ugly, there's a high chance you'll be banned, which I find pretty funny. This is the beauty advice subreddit I want to analyze for this video because it's relatively big but exists in this gray area of toxic positivity, giving the impression of helping, but not really. Let me make things clear. I have no issue with people voluntarily going out of their way to give advice and help others. But is everyone really as beautiful as the comments imply? Does everyone really need a new hairstyle or a skincare routine or a new set of clothes? Is this really the solution to every single poster's problems? I wrote this script in Python, which is a programming language, in about 1 hour. It goes through the r/amiugly subreddit's top posts and puts into a list only those with 50 to 200 comments or more for consistency. Some posts have 500 plus comments, but it's just 500 of the same comment fanboying over a conventionally attractive woman. So that doesn't help us very much. Once we get the comments for each of our selected posts, we end up with around 112,000 comments, which is a lot of data. Cleaning it all up, we can run some AI algorithms on it to do some data science. When dealing with text data and languages, we refer to a field called natural language processing, which is one of the big subfields of artificial intelligence. I'll keep the explanation very simple. By turning individual words into number representations, a vector, it points to a 2D, a 3D, or a 4D, or even a 100D space. The first thing we can do is run a frequency distribution, which is basically asking how many times did a certain word show up in my dataset of 100,000 comments. Of interest, the word ugly showed up the third most, but positive words like pretty, good, beautiful, cute, combined showed up more than any other. Already we're getting the idea that the comments of this subreddit are more positive than negative, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. Statistically, even if only the most attractive people post, however, the distribution of words should be more diverse, not 5 different words in the top 20 for saying you're beautiful or someone is good looking. Also, hair, smile, and eyes were often brought up, but I'm guessing those are to complement those features rather than actually providing practical advice. And so to investigate why the word ugly shows up so often, it is, after all, r/amiugly, but still, I want to investigate this, we use a technique called concordance, where you consider the context of the word in how it shows up. From randomly selecting 10 lines alone, the word ugly only shows up when people are saying that you're not ugly, and that's 10 for 10. Repeat that with 100 lines, and from memory there were only 2 or less out of the 100 randomly shuffled comments that actually used the word ugly in the negative sense. In every other time, it's people saying you're not ugly. Out of 112,000 comments, the phrase you're not ugly or some variant of it shows up 27% of the time. The subreddit claims to not be a hug box, but 27% for this exact phrase and more for variations of it sure feels like a feel-good subreddit rather than one that's there to help people. An n-gram is a n-numbered collection of words used in a phrase. For example, you're good looking is a trigram because it's 3 gram. Unsurprisingly, positive phrases like you're good looking, look really good, you're really pretty are the 18 of the 20 most common phrases on the sub, like robots. You're definitely ugly shows up as 20th most common, which I found pretty funny because that's such a blunt way of wording it. By now we can appreciate that there's a very strong chance that there's some kind of toxic positivity hive mind at play here. Of the close to 2,000 posts scraped, is everyone so good looking here that 18 of the 20 of the top phrases are in absolute awe of their beauty? The last exercise I want to show you is called sentiment analysis. AI can be closely taught that some words equate to positive emotions and others equate to negative. Love is a strongly positive emotion, dislike is a weakly negative one, and so on. What we find is that the sentiment of comments in this subreddit is overwhelmingly positive, to the point of being obviously unusual. It's like when every comment on a TikTok is telling an unconventional looking person that they're gorgeous. We all know something fishy is up because of the unusually high number of comments. Sorting out all of this data first is that there are posts that are almost entirely made up of people artificially praising a poster's looks, and at worst there are posts where around 2/10 of the comments are criticizing the poster's looks, which is kind of the point of the sub, I guess. It's not like the AI is guessing either, because a comment like not ugly is intelligently predicted as positive sentiments because we're considering the context of the word. The not is a negation of the word ugly, and therefore it is a positive sentiment. But here's the interesting trend though. When the user is less conventionally attractive, the positive sentiment for that post is incredibly high. Things like, no girl, you're gorgeous. When the user is conventionally attractive, people are considerably more negative towards them, almost nitpicky. To me, this is the crux of why toxic positivity is so bad. It's self-soothing, but not actually productive. The attractive person doesn't need all the constructive criticism that people give them just because they think that they're attractive, therefore they should be able to take it. The unattractive person doesn't need to hear that they're gorgeous all the time, 18 out of 20 of the times, only to live a completely different life when they log off. If you want practical advice, I recommend you join a Discord server, like the Couve's community, obviously, where the length and quality of the advice is undeniably better. I say this because on a platform like Discord, there is reciprocity, and that's very important. You interact with these people repeatedly, so strangers become your online acquaintances, and then they have more incentive to give you better advice, as opposed to a random stranger on Reddit who says comforting lies to your face to make themselves feel like they're doing their charity work for the day. Toxic positivity helps absolutely no one.